Sir, nakamute po kayo.
Yeah, sorry. So, today we are going to discuss leadership, and that before we move on to the discussion, I would like to know what your ideas of a leader is. Is there a distinction between a leader and a manager? Someone who manage and someone who leads, or are they the same? What do you think? What do you think? Anyone? Is there a distinction between the two? And if there is, what are the difference? And how do we define what a leader is? And as opposed to a manager? Okay, go ahead. Don't be afraid to express your opinion, your idea. Every idea that is contributed in the class counts. All right. May I ask that you open up your cameras, your webcam, that we see each other. All right, thank you, Christina, for responding. How about the rest? All right, okay. Please open your comms. All right, so as we wait for other people to join us in their webcam, any volunteer? Would anyone volunteer, please, to tell me what is the difference? Is there a difference between leader and manager? And if there are any differences, what are the distinctions? Okay. And what are the characteristics of a leader and a manager? Go ahead. Just any idea that you have. Okay. Before we before this discussion, if you hear the word leader, okay, if you hear the word leader, what comes into mind? When you hear the word manager or the term manager, what comes into your mind? Are they the same? Are they different? Are they two separate attributes? Go ahead.
Ano, sir?
Okay.
Siguro, sir, yung manager po kasi kadalasan ginagamit pag sa trabaho lang. Kasi, sir, di ba, kung halimbawa, kung tayo-tayo lang sa classroom, may tatawagin ba tayong manager? Siyempre, di ba, wala. So, yung para sa akin po, sir, yung manager, ginagamit po natin sa trabaho. Tapos, yung leader po, sa ibang paraan na.
Alright. Yeah. Thank you for that. May nagtaas ng kamay. Sino? Si Christina. Christina.
Ano po, para po sa akin, yung leader po kasi siya yung nangunguna. Siya po yung unang gumagawa, pinapakita niya po sa mga subordinates niya po. Unlike po, yung manager po kasi maaari maging leader, maaari din pong hindi. Lalo na kung yung leader po panay utos ang utos. Yung manager po panay utos ang utos. Para sa akin, hindi siya leader. Pero yung leader po kasi, siya yung talagang best example po. Yung kumbaga, siya po yung nangunguna sa lahat ng gawain.
So,
the one who leads po.
So the leader takes the initiative and others follow with the initiative of a leader. The manager simply delegates task. Is that what you are trying to tell me? Okay, yeah. Yon, tama ba? Okay, any other opinion about what a leader is and what a manager is? Anyone? Okay. So consider the following story. Okay? There is not really a story, okay? A manager is someone who let's take for example cutting down trees in a particular forest, okay? A manager is the one who strategize on how to cut trees more efficiently, okay? And he is the one who manages people, okay? He is the one who manages people on the different tasks in order to cut trees efficiently. Now, as opposed to the leader determines which forest in which to cut down trees, okay? So in other words, the leader has a broader perspective. The leader possesses a broader perspective, and the manager is simply an executor, someone who executes what the leader has envisioned. Now, if the manager executes what the leader has envisioned, okay, then it is also possible that a manager can be a leader, okay? A manager can be a leader, but not all managers are leaders. Some people are simply good in doing tasks and organizing things. But to come up with a purpose, a goal, is something that is a character of a different person, okay? Another person who knows what they want to be able to accomplish, okay? So cutting down trees, okay? The leader tells the manager, that's not the forest, okay? That's the other one, wrong forest. So pwede, a manager can do things efficiently, but for the wrong purpose or for the wrong end. But the leader is someone who knows the bigger picture and the what is the end goal of everything. Okay, so the leader determines the end goal. All right, so we have here a discussion of what a leader is. Okay, I would like to show it to you. So I'm now sharing leadership and good governance. Okay, can you see it now? Leadership and good governance. So this is what we are going to study today. So a leader is a person who is committed to a purpose to achieve, okay? Committed to a purpose committed to achieve a particular purpose. A leader is a person who influences people in order to achieve that purpose, okay? So a person who is committed to a purpose that I have already told you that before, that a leader is someone who is dedicated his time, his effort, and maybe all his life works to a particular purpose. Meron siya talagang gustong marating o gustong mangyari, okay? And at the same time, it's not just himself, okay? It is not just himself that he is capable of committing to that purpose. He has the charism, okay? The charisma or the gift to influence people to do the same, okay? To help him in achieving that purpose, okay? That's why he is a leader. However, a leader cannot be said to be a leader unless he himself is committed to the purpose Because there are times that a person are merely simply being forced to be committed to a particular purpose, and that is the case for managers. Okay, so some managers may not like what they are doing, but because they are being paid to do that, they are forced to commit themselves to a particular purpose. Now, the difference is the leader is convinced that the purpose or the end or the goal is what he really wanted to happen, okay? A manager may be committed to a purpose because he wanted it to happen, but the manager may also be committed to a purpose because he was only forced to do so because of money, because of employment, etc., etc. So by example or by meaning, a leader is the one who goes first and leads by example so that others are motivated to follow him. That is the basic requirement. You cannot be a leader unless you yourself is doing what must be done, what is supposed to be done. Okay? To learn how to lead, you have to learn how to follow first. So, sabi nga natin, di ba? A good leader is a good follower. Okay? It's a basic requirement. It's a basic requirement. You know, when I was in the seminary, all right, sometimes we are made to swallow bitter pills. Not literally, okay? We are made to do things that are not in accordance to what we want, okay? Such as, for example, we are not allowed to have cell phones, and that even if you can afford one, we are not allowed to carry cell phones with us. And it seems that it doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense that we are depriving ourselves of cell phones, because cell phones make things easier and communications better. But the kind of training that we receive in the seminary is that we have to learn how to obey. Okay, we have to learn to obey in order for us later on to become good leaders. Okay, there are other things such as embracing a life of poverty, that even if we can afford to have nice clothes and shoes and food and everything, we are not allowed to be extravagant in our lives. Okay, so kung makikita niyo ako noon, my wardrobe would just be a few black pants, okay, a worn out black shoes and white shirts, and then yung mga polo na pang clerical polo, at saka yung sutana, at saka yung ano, but nothing else. Okay, nothing else. We are not even allowed to have food in our rooms. The food that we have is eaten communally, even if ganito kasi eh. In the seminary, actually, we eat not to enjoy what we are eating. We are eating in order not to be hungry. Okay. So we eat in order not to be hungry. We eat for nourishment. We do not eat for pleasure. Kaya yung talagang pagkain namin doon, pikit mata mong kinakain. Parang magre-rebelde talaga yung kalooban mo. Dahil, bakit ganun? Okay, bakit ganun? Pwede namang pasarapin, pero bakit ganun? But we were being taught the value of obedience in order to become a good leader later on. Okay. So the and there is another real reason for that, because one such quality of a leader, okay, the quality of a leader, a very important quality of a leader, is that he is capable of sacrificing things, okay? He is capable of sacrificing things, even those things that they love, in order to achieve what they have set themselves to achieve, okay? Set their lives to life goals to achieve, okay? As a Dicean, you are also a leader, whether you realize it or not. You are a leader not only in the future, but a leader now, okay? Why? It is because you are in a stature of having this excellence and value of God-centeredness in your dealings. You are studying, okay? And because of the things that you know, okay, and the values that has been imposed, or the values that you were able to integrate into your life, automatically makes you a leader, okay? So yung to center God in your life would automatically show in your dealings with other people. And because you have a God-centered life, okay, a life of God-centeredness, people will know it without you telling people that I am God-centered. You don't have to shout out into the mountains that, hey, I am a God-centered fellow, I am a God-centered person, okay? So that something, that character is something that people will automatically see in you, okay? They will recognize that. And because they can recognize that kind of character in you, then it would be something that will allow you to easily influence people, okay? So value of excellence, value of God-centeredness, in that value of excellence, do you really have that? Something like not being mediocre, something like that value of excellence requires that you are not satisfied with mediocrity. You know what mediocrity is? What is mediocrity? Anyone? Mediocrity, okay, being mediocre, mediocrity is the enemy of excellence. Enemy. That's the enemy of excellence. To be mediocre is just to be able to comply with a minimum requirement. That's mediocrity. That's the reason why I said that is the enemy of excellence. Okay? To become an excellent individual, okay, everything that you do, everything that you commit yourself into doing is done with a purpose of producing something nearly close to perfection. Because kaya sinabi ko close to perfection, ano? Because there is nothing in this world that is perfect, okay? Nothing is perfect in this world. Nothing is also certain. Almost nothing is certain. But there are things that we say for certain, such as mathematical formulations, mathematical equations. We can be certain that 1 plus 1 is equals to 2, okay? But other than those things, nothing is certain in this life, okay? And nothing is really perfect, okay? Nothing is really perfect. But we as Diceans who has this value, who live this value of excellence, are always striving to produce things, to come up with things that are nearly perfect or as perfect as they can be. Such as, let's say, for example, you were asked to come up, write an essay, okay? You write an essay. You don't just write an essay and submit it without reading and editing. You write it now, then you take the time to mull it over, the things that you said, and then you edit, and then you come, you take another time to, you take another time to reorganize your thoughts if there are things that you might have forgotten to say, or this word, or that phrase, or that paragraph can be expressed or written in a better way. Are there better words, more applicable words to express the thought, the idea? Do you know, alam niyo, yun lang salitang paglalakad, okay? Yun lang salitang paglalakad, there are different ways to say that. Not just to walk, okay? You can say leisurely walking, o kaya naman ay yung nagmamadaling naglalakad, brisk walking, or something like ambling, okay? You know what? You know that? That when you said a person is walking leisurely, okay, there is a better word for that. He is ambling. She is ambling. There is a word flavor. Alam nyo yan, merong lasa ang mga salita. Kaya nga, when you write something, you don't just, you don't simply write it now and then submit it if you are a truly Dicean person, if you are truly a Dicean with that attitude and value to embrace excellence, then you will not be satisfied in coming up with the minimum requirement, that's mediocrity. Okay, yung bang magawa lang tama na, pwede na yan. No, that is not in the vocabulary of a true Dicean. A true Dicean aims for perfection. That's the reason why, if you notice, okay, I am andito lang naman ako sa bahay, you know. This is just an online class. This is just an online class. But why am I exerting an extra effort to be more presentable to you? Right? Have you ever seen me not in working clothes, long sleeves like this? Nakita niyo na ba ako na ganon?
Di pa po.
Yeah. Because I am respecting you. Okay? This is my way of showing that I respect you. All right. This is my way of showing. And whenever I teach, alam nyo, di ba, na-share ko na sa inyo that I am suffering from aphasia. Na-share ko sa inyo yon last time, di ba? That I am suffering from aphasia, a condition wherein I find it hard to find the right words at the right moment. Okay? I know what I want to say, but it's kind of difficult for me right now, almost every time, right? Almost every time, actually, I kind of find it difficult to f- find the right word, the exact word that I really wanted to say. But even with that limitation, I am doing my best. I am doing my best. That's value of excellence. That's the value of excellence. Actually, come on. Hindi ba pagka ito naman ano, ito na mga pinapakita ko sa inyo na to. Okay? Ipabasa ko lang sa inyo to. There is really no need for me just to talk and explain a lot, right? But why am I doing this? Because I want all of you and me all at the same time to be able to internalize the meanings. Because if we are just going to read it without engaging in a discourse, it might just pass away and we will miss the opportunity to really reflect, on the beauty of what is being said. Okay? So, excellence. Kaya, walang lugar para sa isang Dicean na magsasubmit halimbawa ng mali-mali ang spelling because there are a lot of ways in order for you to be able to know what is the proper spelling. Noong kami, wala pang internet, we use a dictionary. Ganyan kakapal ng dictionary. There is a pocket dictionary, then there is a collegiate dictionary, then there is a world dictionary. World dictionary. Yan, ganyan kakapal. Okay? And the pages are really torn and dog-eared yung mga gilid because we are always, ano, we are always turning the pages of that dictionary every time that we are not sure about the meaning of the word. And even if we know the meaning of the word, sometimes there are other nuances of the words that will be provided by the dictionary. Now, right now, you don't have to thumb through a dictionary. Baka nga may mga kabataan ngayon na hindi marunong gumamit ng dictionary. Why? Because there is finding the meaning and how to pronounce the word and how to spell it is as simple as saying, "Hey Google, what is the pronunciation of excellence?" And that's it. Google will answer you. What is the meaning of excellence? And Google will answer you. So it's the call for excellence right now. The call for excellence right now is much, much more higher, rigid, because of the availability of information. There is no excuse now to remain uninformed because we have an internet that at the flick of a finger, just the knowledge to be able to find the keywords in your queries and almost all informations will be provided to you. Dati, okay, nagpupunta pa yung mga estudyante sa library at sa mga bahay-bahay ng kapwa estudyante kada nangihiram ng encyclopedia, nakikireview, sinusulat na gano'n. No? Ngayon, yung encyclopedia ko, pinamigay ko na eh. Because it's just taking up space. Hindi na useful. Because encyclopedias are available in the internet. Of course, excellence. Do things in the best way you could. That's excellence. And people will see that. Alam nyo, in a class such as yours, there are classes that I have been teaching last semester and last semester. There are classes that I have been teaching where students are very interactive, and then another section would be less interactive. Then when they computed the grade, halos pare-pareho yung mga grade ng mga estudyante doon sa isang section. Then in another section, halos pare-pareho din na mabababa. Doon sa isang section, halos pare-pareho matataas. It's the culture. nagkakahawahan. Alam nyo, the value of excellence is infectious, okay? Infectious. You can infect other people with that value. Na kung lahat, ang ilan sa inyo ay talaga nagpupursige to produce an excellent result, then everybody in the group will really try their best to be excellent. Okay, and then of course the God-centeredness, that we put God at the center of our lives, that we always ask ourselves, if I am God, if I am Jesus, what would Jesus be doing? Okay, how would Jesus react? God-centeredness. Let's move on. Everyone can be a leader, yet only a select few can become a great leader. All right? So, why do we say that? We have to assume that we are the ones that are selected to become great. Well, of course, if every one of us are great leaders, if every one of us are great leaders, then we are simply going to take turns in assuming a position of chairmanship. Okay? It doesn't necessarily mean that if you are not the one who is, if you are not the one who is in the position, is that you are a lesser individual or your leadership qualities are lesser than the one who is holding the position. It does not follow. Sometimes positions are being given in a rotationary basis. All right? So say, for example, in the school, okay? In the school, someone has the title of a dean. It does not necessarily follow that other teachers are of lesser quality than the dean. Do you understand? Okay? It does not necessarily follow. Actually, the deans, the vice presidents, are only capable of doing their job of leadership because of the support of people who belong to their team, okay? And time will come that the dean will become an ordinary faculty, and the faculty who used to be following this person will become the dean. Do you get that? Do you understand? So it does not follow that a dean is in possession of a higher capability and gift and talent to teach. Sometimes teachers are much better at some of the teachers under the leadership of the dean are much better in delivering a lecture than the dean. Okay? But the dean has the quality or the qualification to manage some paperworks. Okay? You understand what I'm trying to say. Think about your leadership as you are chosen to become a great leader. And if every one of us are great leaders, then it doesn't matter who is the president, it doesn't matter who is the manager, that position will simply be occupied by different persons within your circle, okay? It doesn't make you a lesser individual if you are not the manager. It doesn't make you a lesser person if you are not the dean or the vice president or the president. Okay? It doesn't make you less. So, to become a great leader, assume that you are already a great leader. Okay? Do you follow? Hey! Amen?
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Very good.
Amen.
First, believe that you cannot do everything, but believe that you can do something. Yeah. Of course, not everything. Not you are not a superman. You are not a superman. Okay? So you have to admit, okay? You have to be at peace with the reality that you cannot do everything, but there is something that you can do. And with that something that you can do, you focus all your energy. You focus all your creative endeavors in that something that you are capable of doing. Well, of course, you know that you cannot do this, okay? You know that you do not have the capability of doing that, but you can still learn, okay? Something like you can be a jack of all trades, right? So that you don't have to be helpless when things go wrong, such as plumbing, for example, kayo mga babae, such as plumbing. Kung may tumutulo, a faucet was leaking and nobody, or nag-blow yung fuse ng electricity ninyo, and you still would you still wait for someone to rescue you and fix whatever it is that need fixing? Yeah, you cannot do everything, but you can do something about it. Okay, so at least a practical knowledge and practical skills about almost everything. You know, you can cook. I can cook. But I'm not a great cook, pero masarap ako magluto. At least masarap ako magluto at nakapagluluto ako ng maayos. But I am not cooking for living. I mean, someone is cooking for me. Okay? Somebody is cooking for me. Yung may nagtitimpla din ng kape ko. Kagaya yung halimbawa ganito. So I just ring something, I ring up, and then coffee will come. My house helper knows what to do pagkaya yung ganito nagtuturo ako. Just to keep me awake. Okay? Pero kaya kong gawin yun. Kaya kong mag-electrician. Pero hindi ko kaya mag-install ng kuryente sa buong bahay o sa buong building o mag-install ng aircon. Pero kaya ko maglinis ng aircon. You know, troubleshooting. A little bit of troubleshooting. Okay? Kahit mag-manicure at pedicure, marunong ako. Hindi lang ako marunong magkilay. Okay, because I don't find the necessity of other things. There are things that are not really necessary. Kaya, yun, magkilay, mag kung anong ban, huwag na. Hindi ko na idadagdag yun sa mga bagay na magpapagulo sa isip ko. Pero, yun nga, di ba? The realization and the acknowledgement that you cannot do everything, but there is something that you can do, and that something that you can do in an excellent way. So focus on that. Focus on that. And then just add a little bit of extras along the way. You acquire a skill. You acquire another skill. You integrate a new knowledge in your knowledge bank. That's also very important. Okay? So You don't limit, okay? You don't limit yourself on the things that you can do. Yes, you have to focus on the things that you can do because that is going to be your specialization. But you also have to be a well-rounded person, meaning to say that you don't simply study, say for example, in the area of study, you don't just study things that has something to do with management and accountancy, okay? But you also should learn things about literature, arts, sciences, technology, emerging technologies, especially that, because you will not survive the 21st century unless you are not really going to survive the 21st century unless you keep watch of emerging technologies and emerging trends, okay? Trends. Alam niyo, because of my makwento ko lang sa inyo, because of my research about things that are happening, I got involved in I was able to invest in Bitcoin. I was able to invest in Bitcoin. I bought Bitcoin in 2017. I bought 40,000 pesos worth of Bitcoin in 2017. And itong taon na to, when Bitcoin rose to more than 3 million pesos per Bitcoin, I sold my Bitcoin. So yung 40,000 pesos ko, kumita ng 200,000 pesos. Just because I was, studying. If I get to hear something new, I study, I read about it, and I took the chance. Just because of that, hindi naman kikitain sa bangko ng 40,000 pesos sa loob ng tatlong taon, yung 200,000. Okay? So, hindi ko yun kinayaman. Okay? Hindi ko yun kinayaman dahil nagpagawa ako ng bahay na ubos din naman. Pero at least kahit pa paano, di ba? So, ayan. So, even until today, I am, even if I do not have any cryptocurrency right now, I am still watching the market on cryptocurrency. I am still watching the market on cryptocurrency. What I'm just trying to tell you is this, that we have to be well-rounded. We have to be informed on everything, in almost everything, okay? So you don't have to buy a lot of books. If you do not have the money to buy books, it's not an excuse anymore to say that I am ignorant because I cannot buy books, I cannot buy magazines. Things are available online. And maybe you can even pirate. Alam niyo ba yon? That you can even pirate books. I am not encouraging you to pirate because that is illegal. But if you are not going to sell it, if you are not going to sell what you were able to acquire, okay, a copy of a book, for example, that you were able to acquire a copy of the book, or as long as you're not going to sell it, I don't think it is a big immorality, okay? Especially if you do not have the capacity to pay for a licensed to buy a licensed version of the book. Okay? Ako, ang dami-dami kong downloaded books. So, anytime pagka nakita niyo ako nakaganito sa cellphone ko, I am reading books. Downloaded. Now, if it is not available in public domain, I buy from Amazon. I buy from Amazon. Magkano lang ang libro? $5 to $10 usually. $5, $10, $13 at most ang mga libro. Yan. So, strive to become well-rounded, but focus on your specialization. Be the best. For example, ako, I am a philosophy professor. So even if I am reading a lot of books in science and medicine, okay, my interest actually, aside from my interest in philosophy and theology, my other interest is in the field of technology and medicine. So I have been reading a lot about medical breakthroughs. I've been reading a lot about different ways to keep yourself healthy. Plus, of course, and everything new that comes up as regards philosophy and theology, I make it a point that I have studied it so that I would have something better to show and to teach, okay? Unless I do that, I do not have the right to call myself a professor, okay? Unless I do that. That's excellence. That is excellence. Excellence in leadership is acknowledging that you cannot do everything, but there will always be something that you can do. Then that kind of mentality is something that will bring you and bring all of us to that mentality of or value of interdependence. Now, will you say that? Interdependence. Okay, sinabi niyo na? Okay? Interdependence. Now, what is interdependence? Now, interdependence is different from independent or being independent, and really very different from being dependent. Okay? An independent person lives and do things on his own and does not rely on other people. Okay? But that is not the height of maturity. That is not the apex of maturity. The apex of maturity is interdependence. And that is, you recognize that there are things that other people can do better. And because of that, you employ the service of other people in order to do these things for you. And you, while relying on the service of other people who has specialized on that thing, you are focusing on the thing that you can do. Okay? So in a group, for example, in a group, there are people who are good in that aspect. Other people are good in singing. Then there are people who are good in dancing. Some people are good in playing musical instruments. Others are good in coming up with props and decorations, etc., etc. Other people are good in marketing. Other people are good in advertising. Other people are good in soliciting. If all those talents are brought together and used to its ultimate capacity or perfection, alam nyo ang kalalabasan nito? A successful concert. Diba? Nakukuha niya? A successful concert. There was a manager. There are people who can sing. There are people who can dance. There are people who can play instruments. There are people who can do the props and the decorations, lighting, sounds, etc., etc., advertising, selling tickets, etc. You can come up with a very nice concert and a successful concert. And then, of course, syempre, fundraising. Naintindihan ba? Yun ang tinatawag nating interdependence, okay? you don't simply rely on the things that you can do. You have to be a team player. Being a team player, ayan, no? You can, as an individual, you can accomplish a lot of things, okay? So we recognize that. But as a group, you can accomplish a great things. If we work together, work in such a way that we are to invest in each other, even if it causes us individually to sacrifice our own interest, we will end up creating a group that is so powerful in its influence and culture that individually we will end up better off than if we selflessly pursue our own interests. That is interdependence. Okay? Interdependence. Synergy is another outcome. Synergy is another outcome of interdependence. That a variety of talents that a group of people brings will produce something that is greater than the sum of all its parts. Do you understand? Hello? Are you still with me?
Yes, sir.
So again, synergy is a product of a group of very varied individuals who come together, group themselves together, and contribute contribute their unique capabilities in order to produce something greater than what the sum of output of each individual is capable of producing. Okay? The whole is greater than the sum of all its parts. That is synergy. Engage in youth participation. Para sa inyo to. Bakit? It can help promote civic and political life of young people. More specifically, it produces positive social result by enhancing open-mindedness, personal responsibility, social and civic competence, moral and ego development, and sense of advocacy and self-esteem. So, you young people can engage yourself in youth organizations and activities. Okay. In the church, there are several youth organizations, such as maybe a choir, okay, youth choir, and there is a parish youth commission on the youth, commission on youth. Back in our days, we have CYO. Dito sa Bukawi, I am one of the founding members of Catholic Youth Organization. Okay, so that helped me. Okay, that helped me to become to boost my morale, contribute something to the church. Okay, Catholic Youth Organization. Then there are others, and then there is also civic organization. There are also civic organizations as Kabataang Barangay, etc., etc. Now, what does it give you? Well, first of all, okay, which is not here in the slide, okay, first of all, you would have the sense of belongingness. You would be able to identify yourself to a group, and that is very important for a person's self-esteem. And to be able to tell yourself that you belong to a group, that you are accepted to the group, that group will boost your confidence and self-esteem because you know that you are accepted. Because you know, you recognize that you are accepted in a group. It will also help promote, of course, your skills in navigating your skills in navigating political life, meaning you get to be able to function, okay? You know how to function in a group, to conform yourself or not to conform, if what is being done is against your moral principles, okay? So there are a lot of good things that would come out if you belong to a group, and you can commit yourself to that, and to whatever that group is bound to do. So there are groups like religious groups, Legion of Mary, CYO, Paris Youth Formation Center, okay, Commission on Youth, Knights of the Altar, okay, choir. So I hope you are a member of kahit na isa o dalawa, no? It will boost you. Or in the school, you are a part of the club, okay? So it will broaden your mind. It will create give you some kind of personal responsibility because you know that something is expected from you. And then it will also satisfy your need to be needed, because all of us has that need, the need to be needed, that we are recognized as somebody who can contribute something. If nobody recognizes us that we can contribute something good, then it is a blow to a person's self-esteem. Okay? All of us has the need to be needed. Kailangan natin ang pangangailangan ng iba sa atin. Okay? Kailangan natin ang ating kapwa, pero kailangan natin din ang pangangailangan ng iba sa atin para magkaroon tayo ng respeto sa ating sarili. So, it is necessary for moral and ego development. And then, what is that sense of advocacy? Advocacy, anyone here who knows the meaning of the word advocacy? Come on. What is an advocacy?
Doing something wrong without expecting any return.
Doing something without expecting things in return, that's advocacy. A little bit more. Advocacy.
Advocacy means getting support from another person to help you express your views and wishes and help you stand from your rights.
A little bit waylaid, but it's part of it. Advocacy. Come on. Try. All right, okay. Sige nga, meron pa ba na gusto mag try kung ano yung advocacy? Tama naman yung mga sinabi ninyo, pero kulang. Kulang lang, pero pwede nating that can be considered an aspect of advocacy. But what is advocacy per se? Yes, go ahead. Sino yung nagtaas ng kamay? Probably.
Whatever yung gusto nyo pong gawin na gusto nyo masolusyonan sa mga issues na nangyayari dun sa mga environment. O katulad po nung iba po sa mga Miss Universe, yung mga advocacy po dapat sila na dapat nyo gawin. Basta pong dapat po yung advocacy nyo yung makakatulong sa community, sa tao, kaya po sa
development. Precisely. So advocacy is committing yourself to a cause. Okay, thank you, Robilyn. Was it Robilyn? Okay, committing yourself to a cause, committing yourself to a to an end, okay? So say for example you have an advocacy to reduce plastic consumption, okay? So an advocacy like that would result in you at first ikaw lang muna mag-isa that you go to the supermarket pero may sarili kang dalang lalagyan so that when you line up for your grocery to have them packed, hindi ka na kailangang bigyan pa ng plastic bag, okay? And then all the plastics that you have are segregated and reused, and when the time comes that they can no longer be reused, you are would put them in proper garbage disposal, okay? You segregate. So a less plastic world, okay? A world with less plastic in it can start with you. It can start with you. Simple things like refusing to receive a plastic fork and spoon and straw, okay, in malls and drive-thrus, is already a contribution to that advocacy of reducing plastic waste. Okay, actually, that is one major problem that we are facing today. Okay, so it doesn't have to be as big as coming up with an organization to have your own advocacy. All right, it doesn't have to be like that, organizing people for an advocacy. It can be a personal advocacy that you can do. Okay, there are people who are doing that. There is this advocacy of cleaning up the ocean. They every time that they, you know, instead of jogging around, they go to the ocean shore and pick up litters, pick up garbage. Okay, so if everybody are doing their part, another advocacy is clean energy. If you can, as much as possible, okay, you wanted to you wanted to be a less of a burden to our Mother Earth, okay, then you can have that advocacy to use less pollution producing energy, okay, less pollution producing energy, such as when you buy a car, for example, you see to it that it is fuel efficient, or at least, for example, you might consider buying an electric car, okay, so that it will not combust fuel and add those smokes to the carbon emissions. Or in your house, you can install renewable energy source like solar panels. Mag-ipon ka, pag-ipunan nyo. This is something that I am recommending as an advocacy. Okay, right now, solar panels are already very cheap. Unlike 10 years ago, solar panels are very, very expensive. Only millionaires can install solar panels in their homes. Okay, so what can you do? You can suggest this to your parents. Advocacy yan, pwedeng advocacy. Advocacy ko kasi to eh. Kaya ito sinasabi ko sa inyo. The first thing that you have to produce is an inverter. So usually an inverter would cost about 20,000 pesos, okay? One inverter that can handle at least 3 kilowatts or up to 5 kilowatts of electricity that can handle converting sun's energy to an AC or alternating current. So yun yung inverter. So if you have a solar panel, let's say for example, isa lang solar panel lang nabili mo, and that solar panel would cost about, right now, one solar panel, ang cost ng isang solar panel ay nasa around 5,000 na lang ngayon, 5,000. So isang solar panel ay kayang magkarga ng 500 watts. Okay? Kaya mag-provide ng 500 watts ang isang solar panel na nagkakahalaga ng 5,000 piso. Okay? Kung may 10,000 piso ka, dalawang solar panel. So meron ka ng 1 kilowatt. Okay? Yung 1 kilowatt na 'yon papasok doon sa inverter mo at idadagdag sa alternating current sa bahay ninyo. Ibig sabihin ngayon nito, libre na ang 1 kilowatt a day. Sa bawat isang oras, magpuproduce yan ng isang 1 kilowatt. Sa isang maghapon, kaya niyan na magproduce ng 5 kilowatts. Sa isang buwan, yung 5 kilowatts ay na ipinuproduce araw-araw ng dalawang solar panel mo would add up to how much? Okay? 5 times 3. 5 times 30. 150 kilowatts. Okay? 150 kilowatts. Kung kumukonsumo kayo ng 100 to 150 kilowatts lang ng kuryente sa isang buwan, libre na ang kuryente nyo. Hindi na kayo magbabayad sa Meralco. Pangalawa, ang kuryente nang gagaling sa Meralco ay sinusunog mula sa langis, crudo. Kaya maitim na maitim 'yan yung dumadagdag sa ating hangin. Now, malaking kabawasan 'yan sa sinusunog na krudo ng mga power companies na nagdadala ng kuryente sa Meralco. Makakabawas 'yan. Okay? So, dahil kung tumaas naman halimbawa, nakaiipon ka pa. Nagdagdag ka pa ng solar panel. Sabi ko sa inyo kanina, ang solar panel ninyo ay mayroon kayong inverter na kayang magpapasok ng 5 kilowatts. Halimbawa, nakabili ka ng 10 solar panel. Yung 10 solar panel na yon, makapagpuproduce yan ng 5 kilowatts per hour. At dahil ito ay may 5 kilowatts per hour, sa isang maghapon, usually, ito yung solar panel ko kasi . Ang solar panel ko ay nakapagpuproduce ng 5 or more kilowatts per hour. Every day ay nakapag-harvest ako ng 20 to 35, depende sa sikat ng araw, 20 to 35 kilowatts a day. Meaning to say, ang kuryente na pinoproduce ng bubong ng bahay ko ay umaabot sa average ng 700 to 1,200 kilowatts a month. Okay? 700 to 1,200 kilowatts a month. Meaning to say, nakatitipid ako ng mga nasa 8,000 hanggang 10,000 piso ng kuryente. Ang binabayaran ko na lang na kuryente ngayon ay nasa 5,000 na lang. Lahat buong bahay namin ay naka-aircon sa sala, sa kusina. Lahat yan, tumatakbo yung aircon. Pero ang binabayaran ko lang, 5,000 pesos a month. Okay? At may mga buwan na wala akong binabayaran sa Meralco dahil pinoproduce lahat yon ng solar panel. So my advocacy is actually to help clean the air. And In that way, I can help clean the air by, of course, my energy. My energy supply comes from a renewable source. That is advocacy, and it adds up to my self-esteem because I know that I am doing something. I am doing my part to help heal the world. Okay, I am doing my part to help heal the world. How about you? Now you can think about what kind of advocacy you wanted to embrace. Okay? Simple lang, kahit yung magbit-bit ka lang ng mga lumang alam mo na pupunta ka ng SM halimbawa, ng Walter Mart halimbawa, magbit-bit ka ng mga lumang supot na plastic, at pagdating doon sa counter, sabihin mo, eto na yung plastic, huwag na kayong maglabas ng plastic nyo. That is already a way to express or do your advocacy. Naintindihan po ba?
Apo.
Okay. Next, it is important to have a kind of responsibility to be a leader. That sense of responsibility is one great factor and characteristic towards great leadership. No, yun bang you feel that you are accountable, okay? You are accountable, but you have this sense na it happens because of me, that if things do not happen or things do not go right, it is because you would admit your part in that failure to achieve the goal or achieve the purpose. To embrace accountability is to be able to tell yourself that happens because I did something, that did not happen because I failed to do something. Accountability, okay? Responsibility, to embrace that, okay? Hindi yung, kung hindi nangyari yung inaasahan o sa'yo, meron ka kagad excuse, di naman ako yung ganun eh. Hindi naman ako, bakit ako yung ganun? Hindi, no? To be accountable, to embrace responsibility over something, okay? Next. Responsible leadership is always and everywhere a moral act because every leader takes the lives of other people in his hands and take actions in various ways that affect other people, and it is for their well-being to improve their lives and help them become more effective and better individual. No man is an island. Every action that we are doing affects other people. There is so that sense of accountability that we are saying, we have to think about what would be the effect of the words that I am saying right now to you right now and to the future generation, because you know, one of the most impactful career is a teacher's career. That it is not just the lives of the students now who are listening to me, but the lives of your children and your children's children may be affected by the things that I am saying. And that's the reason why I have to be careful. Responsible leadership. Okay, there is such a thing as a snowball effect. Habang ito ay nagsasalin-salin, lumalaki at nagiging influensya, not just to this generation, to the future but for the future generations as well. Okay, we may no longer know it. Okay, matagal ka nang patay, but the deed that you have done today may echo to the lives of future generations and to the lives of so many people in the future. So be responsible. That is a dictate of morality also, okay? A dictate of morality that we take account of how our actions can impact other people and the lives of people and the society as well. Yes, Maris Jose. Yes, go ahead. Okay. That's okay. Take your time. Leadership requires a lot of effort, not only about the heart, what you stand for, your identity, your principles, but also about the mind, because you cannot be a responsible leader if you don't know how to marshal others, organize and motivate people so that they will do same thing and same effort as yours. So take your time and educate yourself, okay? You have, as a leader, you have to be an informed leader. You should know what you are doing, okay? It is irresponsible to simply do things without understanding what you are doing. You have to understand. You have to know. You have to be informed about all the consequences, because a lot of our actions have double and multiple consequences. And so you really have to study all the possible outcomes. And in doing so, then and only then would you be able to really be a motivational leader, a leader, someone, a visionary who can lead people and other and yourself, okay? When you talk about leadership, don't just think about being a leader of many people. It's about self-mastery. It's about having some kind of hold on your emotions, on your mind, on the way you behave. That's leadership. That's great leadership. There are three types of leadership: authoritarian, democratic, and we'll come to that. Okay. So authoritarian leadership is characterized by control of an individual over all decisions with little input from the group members. Okay, that's authoritarian. Ito, it's a top-down approach. Ito yung gusto ko. Okay, ganyan ang gawin nyo. Sundin nyo. Okay. Those who rely on this approach so heavily are often seen as bossy or dictator-like, and work tends to be highly structured and very rigid. The effect of this type of leadership is that the leader is only followed because most of the times the leaders are followed because of fear, okay? Fear. But there is also an authoritarian rule wherein people follow the ruler because they admire the ruler, okay? Even if it is authoritarian, okay? In this kind of leadership, there is little input or no input at all from subordinates, okay? It all comes from the leader, top down talaga to. But the benefit of an authoritarian leadership, it can make decisions can be made quickly, especially in situations where in situations wherein it is really necessary that you have to make quick decisions. Then there is a clear chain of command and oversight. It is good where strong directive leadership is needed. Maganda yan kung ang leader ay talaga magaling. Okay? Mahusay yan kung ang leader ay fair, moral. Pero ang problema dito, the drawbacks, it discourages group input, so people will not be able to own, okay, what they are doing. para bang yung mga tao ginagawa lang ito kasi utos, hindi yung ginagawa ito because gusto rin nilang gawin yon. It can impair morale and lead to resentment. So it can demoralize people dahil napipilitan lang silang gawin yan. May impair or ignore creative solutions and expertise from subordinates. Nasasayang nito ang leadership capability ng iba kasi nakasanda lang ito sa leadership ng dictator o ng authority. The next one is democratic leadership. Okay, democratic leadership is also known as participative leadership or shared leadership. It is a type of leadership style in which members of the group take a more participative role in the decision-making process. They vote. They present several options and people vote. Okay, it tends to focus on group equality and the free flow of ideas. The leader of the group is still there to offer guidance and control. So the leader of the group is more of a moderator, someone who facilitates. Okay, simply a facilitator, but everyone has the power to decide. Okay, so everybody decides. The leader is simply a facilitator here. There are also downsides of this one. There are plenty of downsides or drawbacks. But then let's focus more on the benefit. Let's focus on the benefits muna. Here in democratic leadership, ideas and creative solutions are welcomed, and it will actually draw these a lot of ideas from different members of the group. The members of the group are committed. Okay, they are going to be committed to whatever action that they are going to do because they know that it came from them, and there would be a higher productivity because people really wanted. Okay, they really want what they are doing. Okay, the drawbacks: communication failures. So dito sa democracy or democratic type, when communication fails or when the idea of one member is not received in the proper way by other members, members of the group might misinterpret, and there could be some kind of trouble. Okay, there can be misinterpretation leads to conflict. Poor decision making by unskilled groups, such as if you are going to ask everyone, let's say, for example, in a democratic society or in a democratic group, when creating committees and assigning leaders to manage those committees, poor decision making can lead people ignorance and personal bias can lead people to select leaders to head committees that are not really qualified for the job. Okay, that are not really qualified for the job simply because that person is popular. Okay, that person is popular. That person is charismatic, for example, or likable. Okay, pero he or she lacks the quality to do the things that the job requires. Na ini-elect siya, na ilalagay sa position, kahit na hindi naman niya kaya o mayroong tao na mas may kakayahan. And this is the problem, ano? This is the problem of any democratic type of leadership or democratic government. Okay. It leads to ano, some kind of some kind of dynasty of rulers, simply because they are known or they are popular. Diba nga, no, kung ikaw may sakit ka, no, may sakit ka, pumipili ka pa ng doktor kung sino yung may specialization doon sa sakit mo. Kung ikaw naman ay mahaba ng buhok, hindi ka pupunta sa karpintero para magpagupit ng buhok mo. Pupunta ka sa barbero. Okay? Pero bakit dito, no, in our democratic government, eh, ang ini-elect natin ay artista o boksingero o maton. So, you see, the drawback is poor decision making in government, in a democratic government. Another drawback is that the minority, and usually the minority are the informed ones. People who are like you and me, who can think for ourselves and study and carefully weigh down whatever decision that they are doing, we are the minority. We are the minority. And we being minorities, we are overridden by the clamor of the majority. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Do you follow what I am trying to say? Naintindihan nyo ba yung gusto kong sabihin sa inyo dito?
Opo.
Okay. So, no, it's really disheartening that you know what is supposed to be done. You know who is the one who is really qualified for an office, for a job. But the clamor of the majority who are uninformed overrides the expert opinions of us who are capable of making informed decisions. Alam nyo, sa buong buhay ko, I am already 55 years old. Kahit minsan, hindi pa ako nanalo sa pagiging presidente. Ang ibig sabihin, kahit minsan, ang binoto kong presidente ay hindi pa nananalo. Lahat ng binoto ko, talo. Hindi pa ako nananalo. Si Cory pala. Nanalo na pala ako kay Cory. Okay. Then we have number three, okay? Number three na to, laissez-faire government. Laissez-faire, okay? I am not really 100% sure if my pronunciation is correct, okay? So, i-check natin ito. Okay, laissez-faire. Okay, pakinggan nyo.
Laissez-faire.
Parang Lucifer eh. Okay, isa pa.
Laissez-faire.
Sigurado ka hindi Lucifer? One more.
Laissez-faire.
Laissez-faire na lang. Okay? Laissez-faire. Okay. Laissez-faire. Okay. So, laissez-faire is a delegative leadership, a type of leadership in which leaders are hands-off and allow group members to make the decisions. Researchers have found that this is generally the leadership style that leads to the lowest productivity among group members because the leader is simply just waiting for the members of the group. to make decisions and actions, okay? Itong laissez-faire type of leadership na to ay parang you simply allow things to happen. Okay, so these are the democratic leadership and drawbacks, okay? So yung democratic type of leadership is also in a way similar to laissez-faire leadership. So tingnan niyo na lang, no, basahin niyo. Peter Drucker says there are three things that happen without leadership. Only three things happen naturally in organizations. This is a type of laissez-faire. Okay, laissez-faire kasi is an idea wherein without so much intervention, things will naturally happen. Okay, just allow nature to take its course. This is fair, okay? Peter Drucker says, when things are simply allowed to happen, three things are bound to happen, and that is friction, confusion, and underperformance. So, when there is no authority or leadership, members of the group might develop conflict with each other, friction, confusion. People will not be able to understand which way they are going or the reason why they are doing things, and underperformance because people are simply allowed to do things in whenever they feel like doing it. Okay, when they are no longer, when they are not being compelled to finish any particular task, okay? Kung ano lang yung kaya, so that will result in underperformance. So everything else requires leadership. Okay, leadership in good governance. Okay, governance is a process of decision making and the process by which decisions are implemented or not implemented. So governance is not only in government, but of course in all groups and organizations wherein people as a group are making decisions, and you come up with a process in which that decision is achieved. Nakakaramdam na ako ng ginawa. Okay. So, you come up with different ways with which a decision is reached. Okay. And to implement or not to implement it. Good governance, it is a participatory, consensus-oriented, accountable, transparent, responsive, effective, and efficient, equitable, and inclusive, and follows the rule of law. So, a good form of governance is that it encourages participation from everybody. Consensus is that you don't divide the house in a consensus. Okay? For you to be a very good leader, you have to ensure that everybody agrees, not the majority, but everybody. That is what being consensus-oriented means. Finding a way wherein everybody agrees. And that is only possible when all the pros and cons of a particular decision is understood by everyone. So if everybody understands, if everybody is given the truth and provided the right information, and everybody in the group is really interested in knowing the truth and learning all the information, then and only then is consensus possible. Okay? Now, why is it that consensus is something that is nearly impossible in democracy? Why do you think consensus is nearly impossible in democracy? Anyone? Any idea? Any idea that you might want to share? Why is it that consensus is nearly impossible in democracy? You may call me an elitist, but I am a person who is not really convinced that democracy is the best form of government. I'm not really convinced about democracy being the best form of government. Because consensus is nearly impossible with democracy. Okay. Bakit ganon, ano? Bakit ang hirap ma-achieve ng consensus? Dahil hindi lahat ng tao ay desidido na ma-inform. That even if people, there is an information drive, some people are not interested, okay, in knowing the truth. They are not interested in knowing the truth and knowing the outcomes of every choices that are presented to them. They simply follow emotions. A lot of people are simply following emotions, so much so that decisions are based not on informed, okay? Decisions are not informed, rather, they are emotionally driven. And an emotionally driven decision are usually wrong. In a democracy, you cannot impose on every people, okay, that they should reject emotional decisions and embrace informed decisions, okay? And because of that, and this is the case with majority, the decisions of the majority has their emotions as its basis and not the facts and careful consideration of all the possible outcomes. Kaya tignan ninyo, no? Tignan nyo, sa mga political parties, bakit ang mga pinagpipili ang kandidato ng mga political parties ay yung sikat at hindi yung qualified? Because these political parties are banking on the behavior of the voters, that the voters are tend to vote for people who they can identify themselves with and people who are like them and people who are popular. Okay? Manny Pacquiao rose from poverty. And a lot of people are poor. And a lot of people wanted to be like Manny Pacquiao, who was once poor, but now is one of the richest person in the Philippines. Manny Pacquiao, just like a lot of people, is undereducated. And a lot of Filipinos are undereducated like Manny Pacquiao. But Manny Pacquiao became a senator and learned to educate himself. And a lot of people wanted to be identified with him because just like them, they are like Manny Pacquiao. They are not educated formally. But in spite of that, Manny Pacquiao was able to rise from the ranks. And so they hope to become like Manny Pacquiao. Number three. For so many Filipinos, they are not aware of the personality of people or the name. They are not even aware of the accomplishments and the personhood of people who are educated and in possession of capabilities to become a leader. They are only aware, or they only knew people who are famous because of being a movie star, an actor or an actress, a sports player, or a boxing champion. And all of those things are Manny Pacquiao. So here, you see, democracy is actually a system that nurtures not the right decision, but nurtures it nurtures and promotes popular decisions. And popular decisions most of the times are incorrect. So anong good governance ang dapat? Good governance is that kind of governance wherein consensus is actually reached, wherein all the people are informed, all the people knows what they are doing, and what they are choosing is something that they really know and understood all the possible consequences. Okay? Subukan ninyo, halimbawa may organization kayo. Do not divide the house. Alam niyo yung salitang to divide the house ay, okay, sasabihin mo, hindi magkasundo. O sige, magbutuhan na lang tayo. Magbutuhan tayo kasi hindi tayo magkasundo. Ano ang term na ginamit dito? Let us now divide the house. Divide. All the A's dito. All the nays dito. Divide the house. Paghiwalayin ganyan. Sino mas marami? O dito mas marami. O sige, yan ang panalo. Paano ngayon yung mga talo? Eh yung mga talo, eh paano kung yung mga talo, eh yun yung tama ang desisyon. Eh popular na desisyon lang yung isa. Eh, kasi marami. Popular, kaya marami. Pero yung ano, kaya yung kokounti, sila yung mga talaga nagbigay ng todo-todong pag-iisip at pag-aaral. At yung mga marami na yan ay hindi naman nag-isip. Bumase lang sila sa kanilang emosyon at sa popularidad. Naintindihan niyo ba, class, yung sinasabi ko?
Opo, opo.
So sana, no? Yeah, kami doon sa seminary, we do not divide the house. Hindi kami tumitigil sa pagmi-meeting. Nagpapaliwanagan kami. Okay? Nagpapaliwanagan kami kung ano ang pinakamaganda. Lahat ay nagko-contribute ng kanilang idea. Ipinapaliwanag ang different steps at kung ano ang mga benefits. Okay? Hindi namimili. Hindi kami nagdedesisyon base sa boto. Nagdedesisyon kami base sa pagiging kumbinsido namin na itong option na to, this is the best option. As a leader, okay? As a leader, let's say for example, in a group, in a school, for example, okay? When you involve everyone in a decision making, see to it if a decision is reached not because of voting but because of consensus, makasisigurado kayo everyone will work na even without being prodded to achieve the goal. Okay? So that's what I am saying. So the rest, alam nyo na, accountability, transparency, responsiveness, effective, efficient, equitable is yung pagkakapantay-pantay. Inclusive is kabilang ang lahat, walang naiiwan, and it follows the rule of law. Okay? We're almost done. Good governance assures that corruption is minimized, the views of minorities are taken into account, and that the voices of the most vulnerable in society are heard in decision-making. So you see, the views of minorities are taken into account, okay? Because most of the times, the silent voices are the ones who are correct. Hindi yung mga malalakas ang boses, hindi yung mga popular, okay? Actually, democracy, you know, it's rule of the mob. It's rule of the mob. Hindi ko sinasabing pangit ang democracy. To this point in our history, democracy is the best that we can come up with. That's the best that we can come up with given the situation of our society. Pero hindi yan ang ideal. Okay? That is not the ideal. So, yan. Ano kaya ang ideal? I would like to invite you to read The Republic of Plato. Okay? So, magkakaroon tayo ng break ngayong week na to. Saturday, Sunday is coming. Basahin niyo yung The Republic of Plato. Again, The Republic of Plato. Okay? And then maybe we can discuss later on, after you read The Republic of Plato, the idea of good governance. We keep on demanding good governance from our leaders, from the public office, but have not demanded anything from ourselves. Okay? So, good governance is actually something that emanates from the individual. Sabi nga niya, I think it was Kennedy who said this. Okay? Do not ask what your country can do for you. Ask yourself what you can do for your country. Okay? Or do not ask what you can do, what your organization or your group Porto Barangay can do for you, can do to you, or can do for you. Ask not what the authorities can do for you. Ask yourself what you can do, okay, for your fellow men. Good governance is not enough. What would make it enough is that everyone, okay, are working towards this, are working towards the common good. And then finally, if you are to build a better nation, it is not enough to press for the good governance. We have to demand ourselves, we have to demand from ourselves, each of us, to be good citizens and responsible leaders first in the community and the society we live in. Questions, clarifications, opinions are welcome now. Okay? Naintindihan ba? Maliwanag?
Apo. Apo.
Okay. Now, before I let you go, I would like to ask you, what is your takeaway? Please open your webcams and let's talk about your takeaways at this time. Ngayong meeting natin, your most important takeaway. So what's your takeaway? What is your most important learning? Yun ang gusto kong sabihin. What is your most important learning now? Wala? Wala kayo natutunan? Uy! Wala. Magpapatukwa na lang ba ako sa ahas nito? Wala kayo natutunan? Tagal ko nagsalita, ah. Come on! May natutunan ba kayo o wala? Ano yung pinaka-importanting natutunan nyo ngayon? Hindi ba kayo nag-a-agree doon sa mga sinabi ko? At kayo tahimik? Ha? Wala talaga? Wala talaga? Wala kayo natutunan? Ano pinaka-importante ngayon?
Meron po, sir. Yung ano po, yung kumbaga yung mga tao po kasi madalas nagpapaano po sa emosyon nila. Kumbaga mas nasusunod yung emosyon nila kaysa sa isip nila. Mas masyadong pinapakita, mas pinipili po nila yung tao base sa emosyon nila. Hindi, or nagbibigay po sila ng decision base sa emosyon po nila, hindi po sa kung ano yung dapat at yung karapat dapat po. Tapos yung sa leadership po at sa manager, yung leadership po yung broader. Kumbaga mas malawak po yung sakop ng leader kaysa manager po na siya yung nag-execute. Yun po.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. At least merong may natutunan. Oh, anybody else? Anyone else?
Ano, sir?
Okay.
Siguro, sir, yung pagpili ng tamang leader, kumbaga yung mamumuno sa atin, kaya yung sinasabi nyo kanina, sir, yung sa pagpili ng president, yung iba, iniisip nila na yung sa ano lang, sa kasikatan lang, kaysa dun sa karapat dapat talaga. Siguro dun, sir, napaisip siguro kami. Ako, sir, napaisip ako na merong mas karapat dapat kaysa dun sa mga kilala namin, na hindi porkit kilala na, yun na yung dapat naming iboto. And sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Precisely, yun ang dahilan kung bakit ako nagpuputak ng very passionate kanina habang sasalita, no? Okay. So, I would like to ask you to, this is your this is your homework, okay? do a research about the qualities of or who is the philosopher king. Okay, so that's your question. The question for your assignment, who and what is the philosopher king? And you can use the Republic of Plato in order to understand what and who is the philosopher king. Okay, then let's discuss philosopher king next meeting on Monday. By the way, I told you that I would be operated on, pero mukhang matatapos ko yung klase ko sa inyo because my operation is rescheduled on July 5. Okay? Medyo na kukuha-kuha sa gamot kaya hindi na nakakaya kong maglakad, tumayo at maglakad dahil nakukuha sa gamot. So yun, sana nga eh, kaya lang talaga sabi ng doktor sa akin ay hindi mawawala kung hindi ooperahan. Na kaya lang na kaya lang ako hindi na sasaktan masyado ngayon is that because I am continuously taking antibiotics. Okay? So as I've said, yung sinabi ko last time na baka hindi ko kayo maklasihan ng next week, makaklasihan ko na kayo because my operation is scheduled in July. Okay? Any questions? So basahin ninyo yung The Philosopher King from the Republic of Plato. And then let's be ready for the discussion on the qualities of the philosopher king. Okay? That's your homework, activities, offline activity. Let us pray. Oops. Sige, magdasal na lang tayo ng our own prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. O God, our loving Father, we thank you for all your blessings for guiding our discussion. Please help us so that we may be able to embody in our lives all the qualities of a good leader, that we may train ourselves and discipline ourselves to assume and embrace all the qualities of a leader, and that we may also become good followers, not only of our leaders, but more so of you, that we follow in your footsteps, so that at the end we may arrive in our ultimate destination, our home with you in heaven. We all ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Goodbye, everyone, and be careful. Thank you.
Thank you.